niggas, we be putting jersey on. Take a cheerleader home and see a camel toe.
We don't know Phil Jackson, but we know Andrew though. Flu game, Jay, sick as flow, you a hair.
Niggas commentating, asking how you do that there.
Yeah. Yeah,
We like Michael Jordan in the studio.
We do our
like
duty, yo.
Hair wild like Coolio.
Shout out to Julio.
We like Michael Jordan when we recording. All these niggas bore us, these niggas boring. If it ain't about dough, then it ain't important. I said I'm sorry, but
so welcome to the first episode of the Blades and Bard conversation at the Billionaires Barbershop.
My man, aka Ace over there, cutting. Hey, so the video, man. Like, I'm sorry, you know what I'm saying? The plug right here, bro. This is the shop. Definitely sponsoring the show. So, thank you for sponsoring. Appreciate it. Yeah, plug where you at, man. The location, just in case. 365 Main Street, Stars, New Jersey. Appreciate you.
So, I got some things I wanted to cover today in music. Everybody's also welcome to join in the conversation. It's what we normally do in a barbershop anyway. One of the topics that I want to discuss is new albums coming out. So, who's looking forward to new artists? What artists are y'all looking forward to hopefully dropping this month, this year? Yeah. Who would you want to drop this year?
Off top, Nas.
Okay. Is he expected to drop something? Like, he ain't put no music out though.
He been expecting to drop something for like 4 or 5 years, man. Like, you know, like, the last album dropped in 2012.
Okay. But why do people, are we in demand for a Nas album though?
Absolutely.
Would you, here's the difference when I actually in demand. Are you actually going to purchase the album?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Is he the GOAT?
Yes.
We can get into that later. Let's talk about it. We're going to continue to stay on who we dropping. So we got Nas. Why you want Nas album?
The album's done. He said it like 2 years ago. He said Nas album's done. Right?
So is that a dated album though?
Nah. I mean, what Khaled said in 2016, like the song, the track was called Nas album's done, right?
Okay.
Ever since then, I've been waiting. He's making a lot of power moves, so now we gotta see what he's been up to.
Okay. So, Who else you want to drop? I think Drake about to drop something.
Yeah.
I'm not really a huge Drake fan, but between the God's Plan and the Diplomatic joint, I think.
And then like 12 joints.
You got some features out there.
Yeah,
so
three features.
Drake definitely going to drop. Hopefully,
I think
April, maybe this month.
Probably like more like March, May, April.
May, April? Yeah. All right, cool. Who else?
Nipsey already dropped.
Look, I got that. That's a topic I want to cover for sure. Like, I got a Nipsey topic I want to kind of cover. Maybe we can name his album. Yeah, man. Who else? Where J. Cole at right now? Where's he at in terms of...
Is he needed?
He's definitely needed.
Definitely.
If we think about the way music has been speaking to things that's going on in our environment now, like they're getting more conscious in terms of things that they're saying, it's a lot more value. And some of the things that they're saying, look at the Black Panther album. Soundtrack, right? Right, you heard this. It was substance in that album. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't just a regular, when they made music, it says something. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of artists is actually talking about some things. One of those things, like Nipsey Hussle. If you listen to his album, he's giving you something, right?
So
J. Cole always gives us something.
Does he run
here? I think so.
Like the last two albums, he was talking about that. He's talking about folding t-shirts.
No, he was telling you how far he come from folding t-shirts. This is different.
He said he wanted to. That's what he said. Like for his girl, whatever. Like, you made me feel a certain way that I want to fold laundry. And I don't care.
That's growth. You wasn't folding laundry for nobody. Do you do your own laundry?
I do it.
Right, you got yours? Okay.
So that's evolution.
Yeah, it's evolution in yourself, man. It's just
But at the same time, it's like as far as Cole, is like he's like in his head a lot, you know what I mean? So it's like everything is like in house, like his own beats, you know what I'm saying? So it's like he's not getting that outward. Like, afterwards, not getting that real.
So, I think I know what you're saying. because he produces his own music, makes, you know, makes his beats. He's his own production team in itself, right?
Like, no, outside influence.
Why would I want that though? Now, if I'm making the purest music that I want to make, why do I want outside influence if I can do it myself?
Because you run the risk of pinning on yourself. Like, if you do that, if you don't have, like, if you're not collabing with, like, other artists and doing things like that, you're gonna start, like I said, like, you're gonna make it. Your outlook will be real narrow. You know what I mean?
Okay. That's terrible. I mean, Kanye. You know what I'm saying? Initially, he came into the game a producer.
That's true. Right?
And if he would have stigmatized himself just to that one side of the art, he would have never been one of the most prolific artists we got right now.
That's true. That's a great point. That's a great point. But at the same time, absolutely. Even Kanye has a team of producers. You know what I'm saying? He's not in his head.
Now?
No,
then
too.
You feel me? I think he was producing majority of his own stuff, though.
No, he was, like the first 2 hours.
Well, when you talk about the first album. It was, you're talking about writers.
I'm talking about artists as a whole, you know what I'm saying, like artists, I mean, that's EJ Cole's an artist, and that's so much as a rapper, you know, but if he got a platform to expose potential, why not use that? Well, why just stay jaded to one part of it, you know what I'm saying? I mean, like, that's my point, and you don't have to water down your brand by selling somebody else. That's true, I got to see his steps, that's true, so if I can go platinum by myself, why are you down on that? That's true.
Because my message gonna be altered, man. Because your opinion and what you say in my track. If you mix it, you know, you see what I'm saying? So I'd rather put out my own music. Worldwide.
Also,
you get it?
Yeah, I get it.
Ain't nobody rewriting stuff. Wow.
But he's getting that money in the project.
You guys bring work. And people also get writer credit just for even having any type of. They get a publisher.
One input.
I mean, I respect the whole in-house approach, but it's like.
And he keeping the money in his pocket.
Right. He is.
They get 100% of that, right?
I mean, if from his label, I mean,
their budget ain't. Well, that means when they give that budget, he's got money.
See, he took the boss route.
He did. I mean, he still got paid Jay too.
Because once you start accepting this money from these companies, they own you now.
That's true.
Now you are no longer who you thought you were.
That's true.
They own anything you make under their tutelage is theirs. That's why Nipsey said, I own all the rights.
Exactly. That's key, though.
Yeah.
That's important. Ownership is key.
Speaking of Nipsey, man, how did y'all receive his album?
I'm still bumping. You listen yet?
Are you missing out, bro?
Yeah.
This is fire. Go to Tyree streaming, baby. If you got Tyree, you got YouTube, got the aux cord,
right?
Bluetooth system in there,
right?
Plug it up. Start to finish, you can listen to it. Listen, man, I'm a fan of that Victory Lap album. When I tell you, it's so much information that he provides. How realistic the music is, like you can relate to everything he's saying.
Really?
Man.
Wow. I never gave that guy like too much of attention, you know what I'm saying? I don't know too much of it. I heard, you know what I'm saying, through a grapevine, kind of underground or whatever. I never really seen him mainstream, but I heard him.
Right.
So I never was, I'm an old school dude, like Nas, you know what I'm saying? I like music with sustenance, not taking anything from it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's single YG? I heard that.
I'm a nigga and I can't go outside.
Y'all, they got living bad. Talking and stuff like
talking. Yeah. I think I never knew Ace.
I'm saying nobody really put me on something like
that. I'm a nigga and I can't go outside. Check this out. I believe that it's all about exposure.
Right.
So with us being on the East Coast, I think that the exposure of Nipsey Hussle, even though in this day and age of social media and the internet, maybe it's just not reaching us. If you're not looking for it, or if it's not in your face, right?
Right.
So
the minute you look for it, it's gonna be there.
Right. If you wanna go to YouTube and put his name in a whole bunch of content, will come up for you.
Both for Nipsey?
Yeah,
true. I'm just saying, I never thought that much to inquire about him.
Right, I understand.
You know what I'm saying? Not taking nothing from him and what he's doing with his art. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just from a different era. So if it ain't something to me that I'm, like,
yeah,
it's kind of habitual.
Catch on neither. But I'm always listening, I'm always watching videos.
Right.
And see, so
you can't help because they always throwing them in the rotation.
Right, that's true.
So once you start hitting like
that, you start dropping. He be dropping shit.
Okay, now I see where you're going with this.
Yeah, you drop some shit.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. Like, when I see that,
you see, he was in the chair.
He's in the chair.
Oh, man.
You see my son? Nah. You're about to fall out.
That's some more cool, man.
Yeah, fresh.
Word. I wasn't too aware though, Nipsey, though,
like. Yeah, I mean, he's been grinding.
I'm gonna check him out, though.
He's been grinding for at least like 15.
I wonder how, I mean, I saw a couple videos of him and that. The Diddy feature? Well, Diddy, Diddy not really rapping, but you know, he doing what Diddy do. Talking shit, you know.
With Nipsey?
Yeah, with Nipsey, he got a joint, you know what I'm saying? Where he just talking his talk on it. I think that's a dope fly.
It's called Young Nigga.
Yeah, Young Nigga. That's one of the joints on there. He got a song called Blue Laces, man. Blue Laces 2. He's telling the story, like, as he's rapping, you can kind of, he paid a pitch, especially the third verse on there, right? He talk about being in the shootout, right? His man going to shoot, the gun jam up, he get hit, they jump in the car, he's driving, he's trying to keep him awake, you know what I'm saying, by saying, look, you know what I'm saying, he asked him, they cracking jokes, talking about, at least you're going to be respected now, you know what I'm saying, you done got shot, you're going to live through it, you're going to be respected, in a sense, so you can like, really listen to everything and visualize what he's saying, and almost every song, I don't think there's a wasted verse in that song.
I gotta check out.
I think he should have put a he should have did like a video to each song. I'm talking about in a connection like a to be continued.
Put that thing together, Ace.
You know what I'm saying?
Let's go, Ace. Tell them why they called you Ace.
That's why we here. That's why we here.
Who that boy right there?
Come out fresh, baby.
God. That motherfucker,
have a
flick.
I'm gonna get
blessed in a
minute. Hey! That's how we live, baby. So, I think, you know, Nipsey Hussle, his album did pretty well in terms of sales. Yeah.
I gotta check that out.
It did pretty well in terms of numbers.
He ain't even signed. He's his own artist.
Really? Yeah, no, he actually signed now to Atlantic. But he joined Venture. But he got. He still own every piece of his content. Everything he got, he own the masters. He even said it in the song. I own the masters. So it's basically, you know what I'm saying?
It's basically like more or less like a joint venture.
Yeah. So he get everything. So, you know, I'm actually proud of him, man, because he come a long way. He is.
And plus, like, he can walk me through every step. Like, he can tell me, like, this is what I'm doing. I mean,
he's done a lot of different business ventures.
Yeah, he got a lot of things.
He got the first smart store. Yeah. The first person with a smartphone. Smart store. So, like, he got a couple projects. When you read up on the man, it's a lot of
things.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, he got baby buyers and all that. So, speaking of Nipsey, I got a question. This might be a little, since we got old school guy in here talk about, you know, he like Nas.
Right.
So, in this day and age right now, is the West new artist leading the pack versus any other area between East Coast, the South?
I think everybody putting out that work.
Well, I'm talking about a collective group of art.
Right? New York is really putting out there right now.
You think so?
All
right, compared to the West, let's think about it. Let's name the artists. So let's talk about artists that's out, that's making a splash on the East Coast versus the West, right? So let's think about it. You got somebody like Nipsey Hussle. You got somebody like Kendrick. You got Schoolboy. You got YG. You got
You still got Game.
Nah. He a little more older. I'm talking about those people that's been in, let's say, 5 years now, right?
Right.
5 years, right? Fat O. Fat Jada O. We talking about new artists. They gotta be young in the age, but right. So who's your new artist? You got A Boogie with the Hoodie. His album was actually pretty decent. Who else you got? You got you got Dave East.
Dave East,
probably the only one.
So you name the whole bunch of a few, not a bunch, but a few West Coast artists. that has solo projects that stood on his own, right? That made, that did some type of sales and also big numbers somewhere, somehow, right? But I don't think A Boogie or Dave East did that, put up the numbers. Now,
but the album,
right, the content really good. Both, Dave East,
both. Make sure you do me right.
Joints he dropped. A Boogie album.
Make sure you do me right.
Fire. I think A Boogie album fire. I think they both Dave East joints fire. But, I mean, why you don't rock with it?
A Boogie?
Yeah, A Boogie joints fire.
That's not my wave.
But he got that fresh.
I'm out here, I just came up, touching things. That's cool, but it's like, every time you come, you got the same artist, you know what I'm saying? Like from like the same wave, you know what I mean? Like, let's talk about that same story, like, you got the French, different, different shakes yourself, you know what I'm saying? That's true. I'll drop a Davies for more. Davies is tough. A Boogie's really a good move. He got some, if you
proud of how you come where you started and how you got here, he gives you that good feel. Like, listen, man, I just got here. And think about it. He did set a way when he said somebody put New York on his back. He was part of that. He was part of that. When Troy said he put it, he really did it. A Boogie dropped a single that went crazy, right? That single went crazy, right? So then what?
I mean, because it went crazy doesn't mean it's like...
He started a whole new wave. That's when you start seeing a lot of young...
But Young Ma been quiet after a while. What other hits? Other than who? She had a bunch of freestyles. The freestyle was fire.
She got bars. She can actually spit. I'm with that.
She got Designer too, but that was a monster.
Designer cannot. What have you had?
It
was all trash.
Name
the four Designer singles besides the Panda joint. What else you know besides Panda?
You got Panda.
It was a remix.
Yeah.
Who's on the Panda remix?
I was
a little Panda remix. People remixed it. And he didn't, we wasn't the remix.
Alright, so look,
this song's trash. If my man out here got the fire heart, listen, Ace laced you, baby.
Yeah.
He went off, y'all.
Yo, guys, I enjoyed the conversation.
All right, yo, I
say, yo, love you,
Chris. All right,
love you,
too. All right. Yeah. Nah, so, like, Designer really got hits. Like, people, I don't know why, like, everyone expected it to be Panda, but it wasn't. You know what I'm saying? Like, Outlet is a hard song. Like, it's an anthem. You feel me? Like,
nah.
Now, listen, no, let's
I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling it.
Yeah, Champion.
What's the name of the song?
Outlet.
We can pull it out right now. You said Designer.
Yeah, like, it was his anthem, bro. I don't know where he was at. Like, Champion, like, he had a sponsorship for Champion, like the commercial. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, he had Joe Boy, he had Dak Prescott in the video, you know what I'm saying? Like,
Prescott.
You feel me? Like,
he is my boy.
I know he is. I mean, 14 million people in Iran, bro.
And that was 2000 and, what you call it, bro?
Yeah, it's like six, seven months ago.
June 2017.
Look at the ratio from like likes to dislikes. 21,000, 213K to 13K? Come on, bro. You probably went for 13K.
I'm probably one of the 13. I've never seen this or heard this song before in my life.
How? So if you said it was
how? What you mean how?
You said it was trash.
I did say it was trash. Right now, it's already starting bad.
What you mean? It's melody. You don't like melody?
I'm not hating on it, man. Right now, it's already sounding bad. That's all I'm saying.
Anthem, bro. It's supposed to make you feel something.
I didn't feel it yet. Anybody else ain't feeling the intro?
I play sports. I don't know why.
Alright. I'll be quiet.
Let me turn my eyes off.
Oh, you gonna play it? Good point, man. You got the Designer Outlet. 14 million views. He's close to 15.
What's the name of it?
Designer Outlet.
That's the name of the group or the song?
He is no, one individual.
The artist is the designer, the song's called Outlet.
Why I got this man? Why I got this booger? I mean, you know. Close this down now, I'm joking. It just look good.
For the aesthetics.
Aesthetics, yeah, I need it. Look like we really do this for real, real life.
I mean,
we don't. This is the first time.
I mean, yo.
I already know what I'm doing. Hey. It's the first time. We out here winging it.
That means you're doing something new.
That's always a good thing, right?
You could be an expert of doing new things.
That's another. Yeah,
true.
Oh, all the way go.
Like, yo, if you don't feel nothing, you're dead or something,
bro. I'm a zombie, bro.
Yeah,
I'm listening. So this is supposed to be something.
It's supposed to be good. Based off this guy.
I like this song.
Yeah, a little about you.
You know who Design is?
Look, you don't even know who
Design is.
Hey, yo, this is American music?
Oh, this is American?
Nah, I like it. No, don't get me wrong, I like Design. Don't get me wrong. I'm just joking. I like Design, don't get me wrong, bro.
I'm not feeling it.
I didn't feel that.
That's terrible.
What's the motivating song?
Okay, hold on.
I had no idea, but that wasn't it.
That wasn't it for me either. Oh, you know, I was waiting for him to turn it off. Okay.
Y'all listen.
Hold on. You're
a
minority right now. Hold on.
Let me hear a motivation
song for me.
I just want to know, why is that feeling that way for you?
Back in when electric.
Because you're the minority. You're the minority. So why is it feeling like that for you?
I mean, because that's how I feel. Like, we have to
I want to know why this is Ace's motivational song right here. Why is this your motivational song? Just to be wrong. You got energy, Ace? You got energy. Please answer this man's question.
Yes, please.
You're the minority. Please tell everyone here.
What is it that you're feeling from that song?
Please.
What is it that you get? Because you said you feel it right away. Like, so what are you feeling?
That's a big feeling, man.
Yeah. I've never won a lottery in my life, but I assumed that I would not play that song and feel like
if I won a lottery,
yeah,
I'd be singing a cappella.
So tell us why. I want to know. I'm interested.
I mean, like, the horns just sound triumphant. Like that song to me speaks triumph. So, like, when I hear it, I think, like, my mind goes somewhere that you overcame something. You know what I mean? Like that's how I see it. So it's like, when the first chord start playing, and I hear the horns and all that, it's like, yo, oh snap, like something's changing.
So horns is your thing.
So you kind
of you said horns.
Yeah.
So for me, it's always drums.
Okay.
So I know if there's a certain drum beat, it grabs me right away.
Got that bass in it.
Yeah. So that's.
That's what grabs my heart.
Think about that, man. That's deep, right? Because we can go back.
Yeah.
To where we come from.
Yeah.
That's why it grabs.
I can take you to Brooklyn, to Prospect Park.
Yeah.
Every Sunday, all the drummers, it could be 500, 1,000 drummers, all playing for 6 hours straight in the park.
I believe it. I believe that. Yeah,
sure. Every Sunday.
We gotta go shoot that.
Man, they got vendors out there, everything. It's like peaceful all year.
We'll go out there. We'll go check
Prospect Park in Brooklyn.
Yo, did anybody listen to that DJ Khaled song?
No.
Which one? I don't like some of the music. It sucks.
I don't like it. Let me talk.
Play that. It's
old power.
Yeah. Go top back.
Try to act like you're Puerto Rican.
For real.
You know, I'm a firm believer, but why you pulling it up? I wasn't a huge fan of DJ Khaled.
I'm not.
However, he not a put a hit together though.
Does he really?
Not his, though. I'm talking about his music. The ones he put his name on, I don't like. I don't like his
music.
I like the music that I hear that he does for other people.
My bad.
But the music that he puts his name on, I never liked it. But the stuff he do for other people, I like it.
Pretty good?
Yeah. I don't like his music.
He know how to put the certain amount of
focus. All his hits are from other people.
But that's fine. He not a rapper.
But he does have stuff that he put together where he puts his name on.
Right. Yeah, his name is on this song.
Okay.
But it's Jay and Beyonce and Future on it.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. But he has some where he's in the song.
Right. Yeah. Where he's talking.
And you see his name, DJ Khaled. He's telling the radio.
Here we go.
You know that, right?
It's DJ Khaled. Yeah.
I ain't gonna stop.
Oh, we get sent to my hits. They can pay us.
I ain't gonna stop.
I mean, you take that camera, walk right outside, and listen.
So the drums can feel the drums. Yo, first of all, I don't like his hook that it sounds real dead. It sounds like he did this to the other But Jay bodied this, yo. Jay-Z Bird, he bodied her.
That's the guy who gets paid.
So,
I'm not impressed. Yeah.
You're not impressed?
It didn't grab me.
That's why you guys sometimes do the contest with some songs.
Was that it didn't hit you because there was not enough horns?
There you go. That wasn't good. It wasn't that. Too many had the horns.
Nah, the horn guy over there. Nah, but the fact that, you know, it sounded mad formulaic. Like, how many times is going to that same
form? Look at this guy.
That's motivation, see what I'm saying? That's motivation.
This song like your eye, listen what's coming. Yeah. Like your eye. Like your expect something for coming, wouldn't it?
It's a hit.
Don't mess this up.
I like this.
It's right.
Hey, you're an old head, yo. Ace had me now, I ain't gonna promise to get my haircut. Ace had me in here.
I'm way a generation ahead of you. How many y'all in your 30s?
Yeah.
I'm in my 50s.
I said I'm sorry, but we not sorry. We